Hello and welcome to another Blu-ray pickup video. I have got six titles that I got from the Italian collection, titles that were on their last chance page of the website, so they must be going out of print soon. And I just took the jump and picked up the ones that I didn't have already. And well, we'll jump into it. So first up, I've already done a review on this one, is Alien 2, a in-title only sequel to Ridley Scott's Alien. This is a bonkers movie that I utterly loved, all about people exploring caves, fighting off strange aliens that you never actually see. It's got some real blood and guts and gore. It's got a really nice 70s aesthetic, stars the woman from Krull, which adds another feather in my cap if you ask me, and I just loved Alien. Go and check out the review and see if it's something that you might be interested in. Next up, I have Amok, which I've wanted to see for the longest while. Barbara Boucher and Rosalba Neri star in this one. And this is all about a secretary, goes to work for an author in a large house in Venice. But she's there under pretense because her lover, the previous secretary, has vanished without a trace. And she gets the middle of this cat and mouse game between this author and her friend and this secretary, as they try and twist and use and abuse her and kind of mentally torture her as she tries to discover the truth. Wonderful movie that I really loved. Of course, I'll just say, I've seen all these movies already. There are reviews coming for them at some point. Next up, we have The Long Hair of Death, starring Barbara Steele. This came out in 1964, I think it was, and set in the late 15th century. It's about a woman that's wrongly murdered as being a witch. The king of this community orders the death, and afterwards it comes to him that it was actually his son that committed the murder. But the woman, as she dies on that pyre, curses the land and the man to die. And it's all about that curse coming true as her daughter is brought into that family, as her other relative comes into it as well. It becomes a little bit of a twisted, melodramatic kind of movie that's really fun and has a wonderful ending to it. The black and white photography really suits shooting in that castle, and I think it just adds a whole wealth of production value to the movie. Really quite like that one as well. Next up is Short Night of Glass Dolls, directed by Aldo Lado. This one, it's got a wonderful conceit. A corpse is lying in the morgue and starts to be to struggle to remember the events that brought him to that place. And it's all about a journalist who's searching for his girlfriend who suddenly just vanished one night, and nobody really believes that she's just vanished. And it's just wonderfully set up, and we keep cutting back to this corpse as it's trying to stay alive within its brain work, trying to fire the synapses and remember what's happened to him. And it's just wonderfully executed, and it's really a kind of interesting mystery at the heart of it as well. And then last, we've got a couple of Lucio Fulci movies. First up, we've got Touch of Death, which is a comedy Fulci movie, but it's a comedy in the only way that Fulci could make it. Covered in blood, disgusting, violent, and extremely visceral, as we follow this terrible man, Lester, as he tries to feed his gambling habit by chasing after rich widows, stealing their money and killing them while evading the police, who are closing in on that character. Like I said, Brett Halsey is terrific in the lead role. It's very comedic. You see it not within the actual brutality of the movie or the story, but more within the slapsticky nature of him trying to get rid of people. There's one case where he just can't seem to kill the woman, and it takes several attempts in different ways to finally do the deed. And last and not least, we have A Cat in the Brain, a kind of meta movie from Fulci, where he adds himself into the story, uses footage from his other movies, and creates a whole new tale round about it. And it is wonderfully realised. A real meta movie that deals with the psychological efforts of working within these kind of bloody and gory movies all these times. I'd love to know what you think of these movies. Let me know in the comment box below. I'll see you next time on ManVFilm.